Hello students, welcome to this lesson of art and design. Today we are going to learn about dotism and pointillism. Let us start with dot. A dot, also known as a point, represents a single mark in space on any surface. We often think of a dot as circular in nature, but it can have another shape too. In fact, it is the simplest mark that can be done. Let us have a look at dots that are found in nature. If you look carefully around you, you may come across different types of dots on leaves, shells, fruits, stones, skin of animals, and so on. Here is a crab with different size of dots. A ladybird with black dots. The white dots on the leaves add to the natural beauty of this plant. A colorful fish with contrasting orange and white dots. Another example is the shell of a sea urchin. We also have dots in man-made objects that we use in our daily life, as for example these blue boots. A pretty black handbag with white dots. Colorful dots on this transparent umbrella make it beautiful. In fabrics also, we have patterns made with dots. Now let us see how Aboriginal artists in the Papunya tribes use dots. Their painting is linked to their belief. They believe that their paintings connect them to their ancestors and the supernatural, that is, their past to the present. Basically, they use bamboo sati sticks on canvas to represent their dreamlike stories. They dip into paint and then apply on canvas to create superimposed dots. This process is called dotting. Let us have a look at some examples. The two lizards blend wonderfully with the red, orange, and white. This is also a good composition with a black background. This work is with a different color combination where we can see the different tints and shades of brown. Contemporary artists often use dotism as a technique. Famous Australian artist Elpeth MacLean creates colorful and intricate artworks using only dots through acrylic paint and a paintbrush. Here are some of her creative paintings. Likewise, pointillism is a technique whereby distinct dots of pure color are applied in patterns to form an image. The dots that are used in pointillism are like pixels. Georges Seurat, an impressionist painter, pioneered this technique in the 1880s. He used small dabs of paint as part of his technique. He first put down a layer of paint in one color and then put dots in another color over top. His most recognizable work in this style is his masterpiece, Sunday Afternoon on the Island of La Grande Jatte, painted over 2 years from 1884 to 1888. Let us see other artworks that he realized through the pointillism technique. This painting, La Scène à la Grande Jatte, was done in 1888. both us at Asnias show people on two different shores of a river. Contemporary artist Yayoi Kusama is a Japanese multimedia artist. She is famous for her wonderful installations of polka dots and paintings. Kusama began painting as a child at about the time she began experiencing hallucinations that often involved fields of dots. Those hallucinations and the theme of dots would continue to inform her art throughout her career. Yayoi Kusama's dots obsession, Day, featured black dots on yellow. It featured a room full of polka dots that rendered the fixtures indistinguishable from the walls and floors. This work is entitled Red Pumpkin, done in 1996. A basket full of fruits made with skin print silk screen in colors with lamé on paper. A red and white mushroom. Here are some more examples of pointillism and dot paintings. In this composition, we can see the contrasting colors such as blue and orange. A clownfish with dots. A landscape. Let us now have a look at the different steps required to do a composition with dots. The materials that you will need are painting materials such as tempera, watercolor or acrylic paint, brushes, palette, tissue paper, water, and paper of your choice. We are going to use paper plate instead of paper. Felt pen or brush also may be used to make the dots, but we are going to use cotton swab. You must draw a simple design very lightly in pencil. It is important that the design is simple, as it is difficult to do detailed painting with a cotton swab. Make dots of paint by pushing straight down with the swab, first into the paint, then onto the paper, much like you would use a rubber stamp. After having dotted on the outline of the composition, begin filling the composition with more dots with colors. Keep on adding dots with colors till you complete the composition. Finally, the artwork will look like this. We have come to the end of this lesson. Hope you have enjoyed it. Bye!